My wild life as the wife of a wildlife biologist, what with David's interest in studying the live animal and the sick or abandoned animals that are brought to our research center by people who know of our interest in conservation, I find that I've become the mother of a menagerie. Life is hectic, but a lot of fun. We'd received 4 3-day-old cougar kittens for study and observation. Their mother had been shot by a hunter. Right from the start, Tom became our favorite. Gypsy is a baby gibbon whose mother rejected her and broke her arm when she was a few days old. Fully healed now, she uses those long arms to mother others. The bear is also an orphan. His mother had been killed in a highway accident. Boo Boo always seems to be making boo boos. It always seems to be somebody's supper time.
My main interest was to watch the ways of the cougar kittens as they investigated the wild. Each day their coordination improved. Daily, the menagerie had to be measured and weighed. The best method, track of... But life in the backyard was too hectic for sane observations. We thought we would retire to the house and weigh them there. Thank you. pounds, 2 ounces.
No matter whether it's conservation or general education, David and I believe that concern is stimulated first by interest. Once the children are involved, there's no limit to what they can learn.
They run around on padded feet. I think their spots look really neat. With ears of pink and eyes of blue, they stare inquisitively at you. They love to play, but bother you when on your desk they go poo-poo. The only thing they drink is milk. Their fur is nice as silk. In play, they spring into the air, and of their claws, you'd better beware. Baby cougars, fat, skinny, bright, cute, stripy, short of sight. Black dotted little things, about to fall, then tight they cling. 4 sharp little claws on each paw, scratching up and down your skirt like a little saw. Running, crying, taking little bounds. Messes, ripped dresses, but hardly any sounds. Little blue eyes stare at you like some little stars. Romping all around like 4 little cars. Oh, cougars are fun to have in your room. Don't you hope you get some soon?
Keeping animals presents the constant responsibility of feeding them. Though these young falcons seem to be taking care of themselves.
Even my mundane chores are disrupted by a jealous macaw who loves Dave and hates me.
Oh, David, I love you. Wah, wah, wah. Oh, David.
Some creatures require elaborate preparations of their diet. For other species, the problem can be first catching their food. Here I was swishing up insects for our grouse. Grouse and ptarmigan have seldom been raised in captivity, and I suspect a good part of our success was due to the effort we put into getting them natural foods.
When the cougars were 8 months old, we took Tom and his sister Ula for a boat ride to our favorite island. At first, they were reluctant, but they soon settled down in the boat.
Wow. said cats don't like water. I was fascinated by watching the cats as they went about exploring the wild. Yet never did they go away because of the bond that had developed between us.
Tom would rather lie under the lean-to with me than join his sister, Ula. It seemed like only yesterday that he had been a tiny, helpless kitten, no bigger than my hand.